Well, we've learned from our mistakes and we are better prepared for this second wave. But when it comes to PPE and testing supplies, there's a concern that the demand will outpace the supply. Luckily, hospitals like here at St. Francis have been stocking up on those critical supplies since the summer. Senator Richard Blumenthal at St. Francis Hospital Thursday to put the spotlight on a recurring problem.
We will face severe shortages of PPE, testing supplies, and other essential infrastructure.
But there's a tool in the toolbox for the federal government. It's called the Defense Production Act.
Is a path to quick manufacturing of these supplies. We need to invoke it.
The Defense Production Act would provide money to force private manufacturers to go into the medical supply business. This was invoked in the spring to boost the supply of ventilators. But it doesn't mean hospitals would necessarily buy American-made supplies if they can still source it cheaper offshore.
We need to develop the supply chain here in America, so we are not dependent on South Korea or China.
Although expected, the virus is taking a human toll on our healthcare heroes.
We've gone through some pandemics before, but nothing like this. It's difficult when you can't stop the train when it's right in front of you.
Dr. Jessica Abrantes-Figueredo told Fox 61 testing delays result in more PPE being used.
We've gotten better, and part of that reason has been the turnaround time that we have for testing. When you're waiting 3-5 days to know if a patient has COVID or not, we're going to be using full PPE with those patients.
Right now, all the hospitals are telling me the same thing. They have the PPE, they have the testing, they have the capacity for now, but they're worried about the holidays. Reporting in Hartford, Matt Caron, Fox 61 News.
All right, Matt, thank you. Well, Hartford Public Schools are getting ready to transition to hybrid.